Today I'm going to show you five ways of testing your algo strategy's robustness. This is very important before risking real money, and it took me years to figure this out, so stay with me to avoid the same mistakes. Also, I'll provide you with some free EAs. I've got EA Studio here, and I'm going to use this to demonstrate this, and I'm going to open up a collection. I'll just recalculate that for this. So I've got a collection of 92 strategies. I'm just going to grab this top one. This has been run since the end of 2009 to 2022, so 12 years, and it's a good strategy. It's been tested on Eightcap data, USD, JP1, H1, and we've got a nice equity curve here with a good return over drawdown. The first test I would like to show is the Monte Carlo test. The Monte Carlo test involves performing many stress tests of the strategy and determining how sensitive it is to variations. And it's a great tool to determine how the strategy may perform in unseen data and with all the variations of the market characteristics are always changing. And so how sensitive it is in real life to the fact that it's been tested on previous data and now it's going to see totally unseen data and unseen conditions that has all sorts of movements in the market. So we try and simulate that by running several tests. So I'm going to show you what I mean in EA Studio. So we're in the Monte Carlo tab now, and what it's going to allow us to do is that we perform a number of tests. I'm going to run 20 in this case, but we can run hundreds. And we're going to change, we can randomize all sorts of things, but we're actually going to randomize the indicator parameters. That's my favorite thing to test. And I want to see with a bunch of different variations on the indicator parameters, I like to see just a certain number to be profitable. So if we run this, we can see EA Studio has now just done a bunch of back tests. And it's gone into the strategy and changed the indicator parameters according to these settings, which you can change. And we can see that 18 out of the 20 actually have a minimum profit factor of 1. So that's looking like a very robust strategy passing that single test. The second test we're going to do is multi-market. This involves seeing how our strategy performs on other markets. We don't need it to be great on other markets, as all markets have their different characteristics, but it can still provide a good test of the logic behind the strategy if it performs somewhat well on some other markets. So again, we'll look at EA Studio here and we'll look at the multi-market. So again, it's very similar. We're able to say what our passing criteria is. So we want on these other markets to have ideally a minimum profit factor of 1. There's no way it's going to pass on all of them. Ideally, I just look for, you know, out of 5 or 6, typically 5, just like one other one to pass, really. Now, in this case, none of them have passed that one. So typically, I probably wouldn't. You know, sometimes if you pass 4 out of 5, you know, sometimes there's a bit of leeway if you've got strong opinions about a strategy. But in this case, this may be enough to make me not trade this strategy. And so the third test is to check on different data sources, as different data sources from different brokers have all sorts of small fluctuations and variations in them. And so that it gives us more trades on different data, which increases the chances that our strategy has a good edge. So let's have a look at how easy EA Studio actually makes that. We've got this on 8cap at the moment, and we can very easily just change data sources. So now we've got 400 trades and a high return of a drawdown, and we'll see, I mean, the characteristic of that curve barely changed. And maybe if we go with Darwin X, again, that barely changed, and we've got a similar number of trades, great profit factor. So based on that, you know, often I don't need them to be as close as that. Those three different data sources having so close an equity curve that I can barely notice a change. That rescues it for me personally for the multi-market not passing, because there's additional trades that are clearly very, very close on different data sources. So that definitely rescues that strategy for me. The fourth test is to check out-of-sample performance on data that the strategy is not being developed or generated on. So let's check our strategy that we're looking at for this now. So how we can do that is we can see that we've been working with 2010 to 2022. Let's just have a look. Now, this is a tough one. It may not pass just because, you know, typically there's 92 here. I've just grabbed one and that actually has passed to M and it's performed really well, actually. I wouldn't mind seeing how it is all the way back. Let's just have a look at today. That's actually done great and it's pretty characteristic. So very happy with that strategy, and that's continued on nicely. For this case, I'm actually going to download this one right now because that's actually come out very, very nice, and it's a bit of a top pick. I'm going to put that in downloads right now, and I'm going to explain that in a second. Now, I'm going to show you how we can use EA Studio to take this collection of strategies and check them all very quickly in one operation. So if I move back to here, and I'll just show you, I've imported that collection of strategies. It's going to run on Eightcap again. It's now running to all the way up to the most recent data. Let's see if we use 20%. And we're going to set the Monte Carlo. So it's going to pass, it needs to pass 80% of 20 tests. And the multi market, let's have it pass 2 of 5 of these, right? Now, if I click go on that, well, we've got one straight great strategy come through that's passed all those tests, and that's fine. That's okay. Sometimes you get more, but in this case, very few have passed the acceptance criteria. It's obviously a little bit different to what I actually generated on. I'm not going to worry about that too much. I'd rather just show the principles here. So what we've done is we've taken these 92 strategies and we've tested them on that acceptance criteria. So there's an acceptance criteria that's been applied, and it's right away. We've looked for certain statistics, and only 6 out of the 92 have actually passed that initial test. Then we've passed those 6 into the Monte Carlo validation, and most of them have passed the Monte Carlo validation, so that's great. 5 have passed. And then the 5, we can see it's actually a harder test to pass. We've put those 5 in, and only 1's passed. So this strategy here is our top performer in passing all of those tests. If I download that expert, let's have a look. I'm going to download that one too. It's a different than the one we looked at before. So I've got 2 come out of that collection that look good. Now there's going to be many others that are good. I've just weaned it down very quickly to find 2 out of that big collection that I think look really robust. We can also, you know, we could very quickly perform a little check here, and we can see again that very much was a very similar equity curve on a different broker. And so, yeah, we've got 2 very robust looking strategies that have come out of that. So just to point out, I regularly create content and share my strategies. So if you want to get more strategies and EAs for me for free, then you can subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss a new upload. And of course, if you like the content, please hit the like button also. Now, I promised some free EAs, so I've got 2 here, and I will provide the first one to everybody. So I'll put a download link in the description, and both of them will be available for members of the VIP club. The final and arguably most important robustness test is a period of demo trading on a reputable broker. Eightcap are one of my most trusted brokers, and I'll be incubating all of these final EAs for a period of at least a month before assessing if I should move them to a live Eightcap account or not. For anyone interested in our review of Eightcap, please use the link in the description. Also, please check out the video on my site where I review a great strategy, which is the Dark Titan. See if you may be interested in trading that. Trade safe. Bye for now.